Indeed, as you can see here, looking at a tree trunk in cross-section reveals a series of concentric circles, alternating bands of light and dark colored wood. Each of these circles is called a growth ring. Counting the growth rings allows us to determine a tree's age. A tree gets fatter, or puts on a new layer of wood, every year of its life. We can think of that new wood as essentially a layer of xylem tissue, which again is produced by the tree's vascular cambium. At first, when growing conditions are ideal early in the year, the xylem tissue cells are rather large, cell walls are thin, and the cells are light in color overall. We call this light-colored xylem tissue early wood. Then, later in the year, as a tree's metabolism slows a bit, the growth slows down. Xylem is still being produced, but now the cells are smaller, cell walls are thicker, and the cells appear darker in color overall. We call this dark-colored xylem tissue late wood. Taken together, then, 1 year of a tree's life, one growth ring, consists of a band of light-colored early wood and a band of dark-colored late wood. A ring of light-colored wood next to a ring of dark-colored wood. Again, if you were to magically look inside a tree and count either the dark-colored bands or the light-colored bands, you'd be able to determine the tree's age. As we'll learn, when determining a tree's age using an increment borer, we will be looking at yearly changes to the xylem tissue. Now, what do we mean by changes to the xylem tissue?
As a tree puts on a new layer of growth every year, you can think of that growth as forming concentric circles within the tree. The tree puts on new wood in the form of xylem tissue that emanates from the vascular cambium. The vascular cambium would exist right inside the bark of the tree, a very thin layer of tissue, not any thicker than a few pages in your typical paperback novel. So the vascular cambium will produce xylem cells, and those xylem cells will form a new layer of wood that's put on every single year. It exists as concentric circles because as the new wood is put on throughout the year, the cells differentiate. Early in the growing season, the xylem cells are larger, but the cell walls are thinner and they are lighter in color. So there's a layer of light-colored wood. Then later in the year, as metabolism of the tree slows down, the growth starts to slow down and those xylem cells become smaller. The cell walls become thicker and they obtain a darker color. That's why each concentric circle inside a tree cookie exists as a light-colored band and a dark-colored band. One light-colored band and dark-colored band together constitutes one growing season. And we will count these concentric circles in order to determine the tree's age. And we're going to do so through the use of what's called an increment borer, a tool you'll be introduced to at a later time.